We're not going to go through all of these. They're just great questions, hopefully thought-provoking questions that you can either have to yourself. Hopefully they're not too scary, but Bill's suggestion for our team was to address these with our entire technical team. Get all of your folks in a room together and go through something, an exercise like this, where if you can't answer these questions with confidence, maybe that is a follow-up to consider, what do we need to do for staffing, or what do we need to do to pair with a strategic partner such as RedZone to bring in these capabilities. The ones that stick out to me personally are numbers 1, 3, and 6. So the systems overlap. That's another problem that we've run into very, very heavily on the back end of the assessment work that we do. So finding that the mentality is, well, sure, both of those vendors kind of do the same thing, but wouldn't it benefit me more if they both just do it at the same time? Often that ends up eating up your bandwidth, causing undue end user impact. So looking at that overlap can be really critical. Reviewing your logs aggressively. Aggressively is the piece there. No one likes to do that job. No one wants to be hired to look at logs all day long. And to do it with tenacity or pizzazz or be excited or take it personally when you're not getting the information or gleaning the point of those logs. So again, using a tool that the artificial intelligence and the machine learning does the bulk of that work for you and really only escalates and moves those things into your purview that you really need to be concerned with can help answer that question without meaning that you and your team are going to have to do that moving forward. And number 6, how are you hunting for threats? So this is really the proactive versus reactive approach. So if you aren't hunting for threats, what can you do? What can you bring in to perform that capability can help really lock down this conversation as a whole.